Let us now pray the Oratio Imperata for protection against COVID-19. Please all kneel. Merciful and compassionate Father, we come to you in our need to seek your protection against the COVID-19 that has disturbed and claimed many lives. We ask you now to look upon us with love and by your healing hand, dispel the fear of sickness and death, restore our hope, and strengthen our faith. We pray that you guide the people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem its transmission. We thank you for the vaccines developed, made possible by your guiding hands. Bless our efforts to use these vaccines to end the pandemic in our country. We pray for our health workers that they may minister to the sick with competence and compassion. Grant them health in mind and body, strength in their commitment, protection from the disease. We pray for those afflicted. May they be restored to health. Protect those who care for them. Grant eternal rest to those who have died. Give us the grace in these trying times to work for the good of all and to help those in need. May our concern and compassion for each other see us through this crisis and lead us to conversion and holiness. Grant all this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition in our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers. O glorious and blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Our Lady, health of the sick.
Pray for us.
Saint Joseph.
Pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel.
Pray for us.
San Roque.
Pray for us.
San Lorenzo Ruiz.
Pray for us.
San Pedro Calungsod.
Pray for us.
Good afternoon, brothers and sisters. Please stand as we begin our Eucharistic celebration.
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
We gather around the table of the Lord in this commemoration of Saints Joachim and Anne, parents of the Blessed Virgin Mary, grandparents of our Lord Jesus Christ. In this Mass, we also remember our grandparents. We thank them, we thank the Lord for the wisdom that they have entrusted to us, the faith that they have transmitted to us. And so let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever-Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O Lord, God of our fathers, who bestowed on Saints Joachim and Anne this grace, that of them should be born the mother of your incarnate Son. Grant through the prayers of both that we may attain the salvation you have promised to your people. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the book of Exodus. Moses turned and came down the mountain with the two tablets of the commandments in his hands, tablets that were written on both sides, front and back, tablets that were made by God, having inscriptions on them that were engraved by God himself. Now, when Joshua heard the noise of the people shouting, he said to Moses, "That sounds like a battle in the camp." But Moses answered, "It does not sound like cries of victory, nor does it sound like cries of defeat. The sound that I hear are cries of revelry." As he drew near the camp, he saw the cup and the dancing. With that, Moses' wrath flared up, so that he threw the tablets down and broke them on the base of the mountain. Taking the calf they had made, he fused it in the fire and then ground it down to powder, which he scattered on the water and made the children of Israel drink. Moses asked Aaron, "What did these people ever do to you that you should lead them into so grave a sin?" Aaron replied, "Let not my Lord be angry. You know well enough how prone the people are to evil. They said to me, 'Make us a God to be our leader.' As per the man Moses who brought us out of the land of Egypt, we do not know what has happened to him." So I told them, "Let anyone who has gold jewelry take it off." They gave it to me, and I threw it into the fire, and this cup came out. On the next day, Moses said to the people, "You have committed a grave sin. I will go up to the Lord then. Perhaps I may be able to make atonement for your sin." So Moses went back to the Lord and said, "Ah, this people has indeed committed a grave sin in making a god of gold for themselves. If you would only forgive their sin, if you will not, then strike me out of the book that you have written." The Lord answered, "Him only who has sinned against me will I strike out of my book. Now, go and lead the people to the place I have told you. My angel will go before you. When it is time for me to punish, I will punish them for their sin." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good.
Our fathers made a calf in Horeb and adored a molten image. They exchanged their glory for the image of a grass-eating bullock.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good.
They forgot the God who had saved them, who had done great deeds in Egypt, wondrous deeds in the land of Ham, terrible things at the Red Sea.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good.
Then he spoke of exterminating them, but Moses, his chosen one, withstood him in the breach to turn back his destructive wrath.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. Please stand.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus proposed a parable to the crowds. The kingdom of heaven is like a mustard seed that a person took and sowed in a field. It is the smallest of all the seeds, yet when full grown, it is the largest of plants. It becomes a large bush, and the birds of the sky come and dwell in its branches. He spoke to them another parable. The kingdom of heaven is like yeast that a woman took and mixed with 3 measures of wheat flour until the whole batch was leavened. All these things Jesus spoke to the crowds in parables. He spoke to them only in parables to fulfill what had been said through the prophet. I will open my mouth in parables. I will announce what has lain hidden from the foundation of the world. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
If there is something common between our readings for this day, that would be the word or the virtue of patience. If we will look back at our first reading, what pushed the Israelites to sin against the Lord? It is because they have grown tired of waiting for Moses to come down from the mountain. They grew impatient what will happen after they have been led to the desert. They felt that there was a void. It seemed for them that God was absent. They can no longer feel that God who led them out of Egypt. They cannot wait any longer for the absence of Moses as their leader. That's why they ask Aaron to lead them and build for themselves a molten calf to be their God. That seeming absence tested their patience, and they were not patient enough. And that is also the same message that Jesus was trying to convey in his parables in our gospel. It would also take time for our faith to grow. We may see our faith starting when we were young. The moment that we were baptized as children, we have been initiated to the Christian faith. And as we grow in age, hopefully, we also mature in our faith. We can easily understand it if we just try to picture out ourselves growing physically. But our faith would also mature depending on how we nurture it. Nurturance would need time and patience. Our faith does not grow in an instant. It is through our experiences that we could say that our faith constantly develops. And as we recognize that this faith also develops, then hopefully we can also see how that faith that we possess can also be a blessing for others. A mature faith is never self-serving. It is for us to become a channel of blessing for others. We allow others to be blessed by how much we have grown in our faith. And if we try to look deeply, Jesus did not end his parable with the growth of the mustard seed. He showed to us how that little seed also became a blessing for the birds of the sky to have its branches as their dwelling. And in the same way, the bread that was baked was not for aesthetic purposes. The moment that the wheat became leavened and bread to eat, it is no longer a simple yeast, but it has become food for the nourishment of others. Hopefully, that is also the progress that we can see with our faith. First, for our faith to grow, it would also mean our nurturance that is developed through time and patience. We may find ourselves questioning what God wants from us. Or sometimes, like the Israelites, we may see God as a distant or absent God. But it is in those moments that we try to cling on to that absence. Because it only means that we must also search for God out of the ordinary or out of our usual experiences. We try to search deep within because for sure, God is there waiting for us. And secondly, we allow our faith to grow not only for ourselves, but also for us to become a blessing for others. The faith that we have received is a gift. And the moment we acknowledge it as a gift, then we allow that faith to become a gift also for others. Because it simply means we are moving towards selflessness and not towards selfishness.
Please stand.
With Saints Joachim and Anne, let us trust in the Lord who knows the needs of our families and the community of the Church. For every intention, we will say, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Church may defend the sanctity of marriage and the value of family life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That parents may inculcate in the minds and hearts of their children the ways of love and holiness. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That children may respect and love their parents and grandparents. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That couples who are estranged from one another may rediscover and appreciate one another in the spirit of peace, forgiveness, and reconciliation. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That God may grant peace to our deceased family members. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord God, bless our homes. Unite your sons and daughters in the one family of your Church. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness you have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, to become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Receive, we pray, O Lord, these offerings of our homage, and grant that we may merit a share in the same blessing which you promised to Abraham and his descendants. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For in the marvelous confession of your saints, you make your church fruitful with strength ever new, and offer us sure signs of your love, and that your saving mysteries may be fulfilled, their great example lends us courage, their fervent prayers sustain us in all we do. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks, as in exaltation we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, and Jose our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, with Saints Joachim and Anne, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold Jesus. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. But only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
The body of Christ.
Amen.
Act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Please stand.
Let us pray. O God, who will that your only begotten Son should be born from among humanity, so that by a wonderful mystery, humanity might be born again from you. We pray that in your kindness you may sanctify by the Spirit of adoption those you have fed with the bread you give your children. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.